MedCram.com.
Welcome to another MedCram lecture. This is the beginning of a series where we're going to talk about the Chem 7, as it's known, or the basic metabolic panel. And this is the structure that the Chem 7, or basic metabolic panel, is usually delivered in. And this first column here are the positive charges, and we'll talk about that. That's sodium and potassium. Those are the abbreviations. The middle column here are the negative charges, chloride and bicarbonate. This is otherwise known as CO2. You'll see that written a number of times. So bicarbonate is actually measured as CO2, and so you'll see this expressed as carbon dioxide, but it's really measuring the bicarbonate concentration. This third column has to do with the kidney, and we have the BUN. Never call it the bun, call it the BUN. And then here at the bottom, we have the creatinine. And then here, finally, at the very end, we have glucose. Now, the units that these things are reported in, this first column is milliequivalents per liter, or another way of saying it is millimoles per liter. And that goes for all of these here on the left-hand column. Same with this middle column. This is also milliequivalents per liter, or millimoles per liter. The BUN and the creatinine, however, are expressed in milligrams per deciliter, and glucose also in milligrams per deciliter. Now, outside of the United States, sometimes these are expressed differently as well, depending on the units, and so we'll be sticking to milligrams per deciliter. And so I want you to notice that the first column are positive charges, the second column are negative charges. The third column here has to do with the kidney, and again, this is the glucose. And so that's the basic pattern that we're going to be using. Now, in this series, we're going to be going into detail in each one of these seven values. Now, sodium is a very important marker in the body. It's also a very important ion. It is important in terms of water and fluids and compartment and spaces. Potassium is very important in terms of electrical conduction in neurons. And it's also very important in cardiac conduction as well as other things. Chloride is the counter ion for sodium, and we'll see that it depends a lot on the sodium concentration. We'll also see, of course, with bicarbonate is very important with acid base, buffering and things of that nature that has to do with the kidneys. And here we have the kidneys and we have the BUN, which is filtered in the glomerulus, but also reabsorbed. And we have the creatinine, which is filtered at the glomerulus, but also excreted in the distal convoluted tubule. And we'll talk more about the BUN and the creatinine. And then finally, we'll also talk about the glucose concentration and what that has to do with. Now, all of these items are very strictly regulated in the body. And so we're going to be talking about when these things are low and when these things are high, and what are the systems that regulate them to keep them in the normal range. So join us as we talk about sodium first, and we'll go on to the rest of these items. Thanks for joining us.